praise y'all about some y'all shot.
¿Cuál es la imagen de él? ¿Cuál es su imagen? Él fue un hombre que caminó la tierra, ¿no? ¿Cómo se mira? Sí, eso mero.
Okay.
Ustedes tienen, su libro tiene, ¿verdad? Tiene la imagen, ¿no?
Sí, tenemos.
¿Quiero verlo? ¿Me lo enseñan?
No sé si...
Okay. I'm asking you a question, seriously. You know, I mean, I understand you're asking this gentleman something, but I'm here talking to this gentleman, and you gentlemen come up to him and talk to him while I'm talking to him. So now you're into our conversation, so I'm involved in this as well. Anyways, correct?
I'm just asking you a question.
Okay, but am I correct, yes or no?
No, you're not correct, because we have a scholar here, and we have a scholar here, and we have you drinking beer here.
Okay, but I'm asking a question.
You're inebriating your alcohol, so you can sit back and just listen.
Okay, but I'm asking you, because you said, how does God look? How can this man judge? How can this man say, how does God look? When he wasn't born then.
This is the reason why. 1 John 4:2. Hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is of God. So Christ came in the flesh. Christ had a color, he had a body, he had a nationality, he had a heritage, he had an ethnicity, he had texture to his hair, and he had color to his skin.
Which is just regular human, right? Just he bleeding like us, right?
What does human mean? You means color, man means man. Everybody's not human. Does the white man have color?
Yes, he has color. Okay, so you're telling me the white man is not no color.
He's the devil. That's what he is. He's the devil. And that's why he took your lamb from you. He still think he's a good person.
I'm not saying he's a good person, but he is still a man. He's still peace. He's still peace, just as any other man.
Does everybody have the same blood type?
No.
No. So he's not a man. All men are not the same. But go ahead. Let's see.
The blood is still the same color, red.
Esta es su imagen, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad? Vamos, ¿está de acuerdo con el juego de béisbol?
¿De béisbol?
Sí, sabe cómo se juega, ¿verdad? One, two, three, strike, ¿verdad? Ok. Léame eso.
¿Sí?
Sí.
Este es el libro del Apocalipsis, capítulo 1, versículo 1.
Lea.
Revelación de Jesucristo, de Dios. Señor le dio para mostrar a sus siervos las cosas que deben suceder enseguida.
Pero esta es la revelación de Cristo, él se va a revelar, ¿verdad? ¿Podemos estar de acuerdo a eso? ¿Qué quiere decir revelación? ¿Y qué quiere decir ilustración?
What's
an illustration?
Illustration is when you make an example.
A visual. Okay. We can agree with that, right? It's an audición, ¿verdad? Yeah, that's
versículo 2. Y me volví para ver la voz que hablaba conmigo.
Él volvió a ver la voz que hablaba con él. So él vio algo, ¿verdad? Está viendo algo, ¿sí vale?
Y al volverme, vi 7 candeleros. El
volvió a ver esto, está de acuerdo a esta, ¿verdad? Los 7 candelarios. Sígale.
Versículo 13. Y en medio de los 7 candeleros, a uno semejante al Hijo del Hombre.
¿Quién es el Hijo del Hombre? ¿Quién es ¿quién es el Hijo del Hombre?
Ahora tú estás leyendo
la... No, yo estoy leyendo las Escrituras, pero ¿quién es el Hijo del Hombre? Ok, otra pregunta. ¿Quién se refirió él mismo como el Hijo del Hombre? No sabes, si no sabes, ya no sé, yo le respondo. Entonces, ¿quién es? Ok, ¿verdad? Jesucristo, ¿verdad? Jesucristo era el Hijo del Hombre, sígale.
Vestido en una ropa que llegaba hasta los pies.
Amen, ¿qué refieres? Estaba vestido como en una ropa similar a esto, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad? Así era la ropa, sígale.
Y ceñido por el pecho con un cinto de oro.
Tenía un cinto de oro, ¿verdad? ¿Sabes viendo cómo estaba vestido? Sígale.
Versículo 14. Cabeza y sus cabellos eran blancos.
Sus cabezas y sus cabellos eran blancos, ¿verdad? Este tiene pelo café. Sígale. Vemos, hermano, está leyendo la escritura. Sígale.
Como blanca lana.
Como la blanca lana. Tenía textura blanca como la lana. ¿Puedo leer la Biblia? ¿Puedo leer el manual? Ok, vamos a seguir leyendo la Biblia. Sígale.
Como nieve. Como ojos.
También era nieve y como la nieve. Es la textura. Vaya. Right quick. Así es la textura de la nieve. Esta es la textura de la lana, ¿verdad? Blanca como la nieve y blanca como la lana, ¿verdad? Es lo que dice la textura, ¿verdad? Sus ojos se le llaman de fuego. Eso es lo que se
llama de fuego. Ya son 2. ¿Verdad? Versículo 15. Y sus pies semejantes.
Deja los que hablan primero y después tú hablas lo que tú quieres decir. Sea lo que hablas. Sea lo que quieres decir.
Gracias.
Ok, y sus pies semejante a bronce bruñido.
¿Qué color es el bronce bruñido? Es café, ¿verdad? ¿L?
Refulgente, como en un horno.
Quemado, como en un horno. Se está como el color de la piel, ¿sí? Aquí. ¿O los pies están on fire? No. Does your skin look the same as the rest of your body? Does your feet, Does your feet look like the rest of your body? Okay, so he's saying his feet are black. He has woolly, white woolly hair.
Okay, but you're reading it in Spanish. Can you read it in English too?
Okay, can somebody give me in English. Somebody give it to me in English.
I'm reading all this and I'm not even...
Okay, so you know what? The brother wants to listen, so we're going to edify him.
Thank you.
Since he don't want to listen.
You got to get the physical, so I don't want to give him no excuse.
No, I'm going to give you a King James
physical. Just keep going. Just keep playing. He can understand the Spanish. He can understand English. I can understand Spanish and English, but stuff that I'm not even understanding nothing you're saying. So right, whatever you're saying,
Whatever you ask him to read, 13 and 14, right? Yeah, I'm starting verse 1.
Book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
I'm not deaf, brother.
It says, the revelation of Jesus Christ.
So what's a revelation? A revealing, right? A vision. Go ahead.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants things which must shortly come to pass.
So he gave them to show them to his servant so he can see what's about to happen. Go ahead.
And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
So he
through
signified
his
it?
Angel.
Yeah, through his angel.
Through his angel.
Yeah.
Through another man.
Through an angel. Go ahead. Give me verse 12.
Verse 12.
Which is, what's his angel's name?
It doesn't say. It just says an angel.
Just an angel. Okay. Go ahead.
Verse 12. And I turned to see the voice that spake with me.
So he turned around and saw the voice that was speaking with him. Go ahead.
And being turned, I saw 7 golden candlesticks.
So what he saw was 7 golden candlesticks, just right here, menorah. Go ahead.
And in the midst of the 7 candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man.
So the Son of Man, if you go through scripture, is Christ. He said the Son of Man is like, the Son of Man is this, the Son of Man is that. Christ always refers to himself as the Son of Man. Go ahead.
clothed with a garment down to the foot.
So he had a garment all the way down to his foot. Go ahead.
And girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
So he had was similar to a championship belt that's made out of gold. Go ahead.
Give me the Howard Sharks
side. It says his head.
So.
It says his head and his hairs were white like wool.
So his hair and his head was white like wool. Who has woolly hair?
Who has wool hair?
What group of people, what nation of people, what group ethnicity has woolly hair?
Woolly hair?
Black people, right? Even some Hispanics.
My
exactly. See, so he has white woolly hair. Go ahead.
As white as snow.
So now it's telling you the color and the texture of what's going on. So this is what it's describing right here. This is what they show you in the Christian and Catholic and even these people's churches. Go ahead.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So his eyes were a flame of fire. His eyes aren't a flame of fire. Go ahead.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So his feet were like unto fine brass. So what color is brass? What color is brass, bro?
Brass.
Brass is brown, right? Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Oh. As if they burn in a furnace.
Okay. Yeah, get Proverbs 21:1 now. I'm gonna continue.
I understand what you guys are doing. You know what I mean? I was talking to the gentleman you guys were doing. You guys come over here and start your thing, you know what I mean? And I respect what you guys are doing. You know what I mean? You guys have your own opinion.
We don't have an opinion, we come out of the Bible. It's fact we have. You got that?
Who wrote that Bible?
What's it? 21?
Read it down.
Who wrote that Bible?
This is the libro de Proverbios, capítulo 28, versículo 1.
Lea.
Read
that in English. Read that in English, brother.
Que nadie lo...
El impío, el malvado, él corre cuando nadie lo persigue.
You guys are God. Why would you do that to another person of religion?
Yeah.
Proverbs chapter 28.
I don't hear what
he's saying. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 1. The wicked flee when no man pursue it.
I don't care. I didn't touch
him. The wicked flee when no man pursue it. The wicked flee when no man pursue it. Pursue it, but the righteous are bold as a lion.
All right.
The wicked flee when no man pursue it, but the righteous are bold as a lion.
So we need to set up so everything else is out.
I'm trying. So the lion are pursuing. Are you guys being the lion and being pursued of another people?
They're wicked.
Anyone who wasn't fighting the Romans was a collaborator and worthy of death.
Many were slain every day, and the fear men were in was worse than the calamity itself.
The Sicarii fighters are motivated by a deeply held belief in God, freedom, and the independence of their country. They're famed for their fanaticism and their vicious dagger. The Sicarii are one of the only guerrilla groups never to bow to the might of the Roman Empire.
The Sicarii were guerrillas.
Guerrilla warfare.
It was a perfect gap for a guerrilla unit.
But for the Sicarii, surrender is not an option.
Fanatical groups like the Sicarii never surrender. They never surrender because what their aims are not negotiable.